Hey guys, Nick here today, and this is just a real quick episode of whoops. Oh god, what did I do? Oh, anyway, this is just a quick episode of Piston Contraptions. Actually, this would be a better way to make it. One sec, sorry, I just gotta make this real quick. Anyway. What did I say? Piston contrapt? I meant, this is, the first episode of Advanced Redstone Contraptions. So basically, what I'm going to be doing. Okay. And then have it like that, with the power coming from there. So normally this would be, like, one way that you would make this would be sort of one way that you make a redstone 2x1 piston door, you know, with this. You don't actually have to have this. To make it a lot easier, you could just really I don't know why I did that, just like that. You flip it, it turns off. Simple as that. But, well, I like making things complicated, and I'll need 2 flip-flops in this. I haven't done a redstone tutorial on those yet, so I just wanted to, so I'll show you how to do it. So, basically, I'm making a 2x1 piston door, but as you can see, it's a little more complicated than people usually do. Anyway, I have it set up so it goes 2 different paths. This path is the open path, where it opens the door. And this path is the closed path, where it closes the door. Right now, the closed path is activated and the open path is off, but as you can see, it's closed, so we're gonna switch that. Anyway, I have to build 2 T flip-flops so that I can get this all set up. Anyway, I'm gonna have to move this activation switch because, well, I'm gonna have to have it over here, so when they press the button, they can get in. Anyway, you could easily just cover all of this up. Oh, I guess except for that. Don't worry, you could build, like, a little ramp or something over it. A little bridge. Yes, all this redstone is in some way concealable. I don't even use this anymore. That little part. There. That should be right. Hopefully it didn't mess with any of the contraptions or anything like that. See, it's completely hidden. I have to just set it so the button is, like, right here, probably. Yeah, I could have it going over and around. I guess I better leave that there. Okay, I just need a button. A button. Yeah, I'll show you how it works after. Let me just set it up real quick. I'll show you how a T-flip-flop is made first thing, though. So, this is how you make a T-flip-flop. Place one there, place one there. 2 holes. Redstone torch. Redstone. This. That's not all. Don't worry. I don't know if you have to break that, but I always do, so I would. It also gives you a little more access. This one on this side, one on this side. And here. And this is how you make it, basically. And then you just attach it to a switch. Finish the line. Okay, sorry about that. I don't know why it's not working. This is weird. Let's try it again. Just give me a sec. I know I did it right, but something's wrong. Right, okay, I think this is the problem. You're not actually supposed to put that in, maybe? I don't know. I'm just gonna leave it out. Because I think you might put the power source in, but it works if you don't, so flippy flip, it opens up, the power transfers, and you can open a door. There. Ta-da! And you click it again. It's just so that you can have a button that opens and closes. Like, a button that makes things turn on and off. That's really the whole point of it. I can't really think of too much of a good reason to want to use it, except for right now, how I'm gonna show... I'm gonna go build it real quick, and then I'll connect it up and show you how everything... Okay, everything should be in working order. One sec, actually. Okay, I just had to switch the signals so that on started first, so that right as it starts, it turns on. Let's just finish this up and make it look nice. I know dirt doesn't look that nice, but it'll just have to do for now, anyway. Actually, let me just dirt this. I guess I could do it on video. It's not much happening anyway. So, yeah, there's a lot more simple, and I'm sure you can get it more compact, but I, honestly, before I make any of these redstone videos and whatnot, I actually spend, like, an hour on the wiki and looking at videos, learning it myself, because I want to show others how to use redstone while learning it myself. So, it's, you know, it's the best way, it's just the best way to do it. So, yeah. So yeah, this is going to be not very compact, but I might come back in a later video when I know more about redstone and make it more compact. Anyway, it's going to take a little bit for the door to open, but let's see if it works. And apparently not. Let's figure out where it went wrong. I press the button, right? Sends the signal. This one didn't send the signal. Actually, this needs to go. These two need to be delayed. Okay, well, it should work now. I don't think it's 15 and 15. Okay, the signal, it gets lost somewhere. I wish I had someone else with me to help press the buttons while I figure all this out. It's not making it here, that's for sure. Okay. Oh, I think it's too many blocks in between. Duh. Okay. It should work now. If all my calculations are correct. Ta-da! And then if you don't want anything else to be shown, you can cover. Oh god! Okay. I hope that didn't mess anything up. I'm just very worried about that doesn't actually need to be there. Oh, I cannot lock that off. Let's try using as little as possible. Because you're going to have to be able to see the piston, which doesn't matter too much because you're going to be seeing the top of it anyway. Up another stair. And we are in the clear. Oh yeah. Okay, you know what, I'm just gonna jump cut because this isn't really important. I'm just showing you how to hide. Okay, let's just test the close real quick. I prefer not to trap myself in. Perfect! That is amazing. Okay, see, you could even hide it all. There's no way of seeing through that, and it's pretty hard to see through this. You could even put another layer up, though. Anyway, this is how it works. So this hits, it sends the signal to this. These are just extenders to make it so that the signal can go farther. Here's where it gets a little complicated. So first, it goes off to the T flip-flops. It activates the T flip-flops and inverts the signal. Now, both of these are different. So while this one is going, this one is also going. But this one has that redstone torch there, so that the signal is inverted. So when this one is activated, this one is closed. When this one is activated, this is open. So, using this, right, see these two delay the timer, so when it's activated, the signals go out, and then it waits like one, two, just enough for this to go through and get through here. And then this shuts, pulls back, and this one comes out because both the signals inverted and they both turned off. Then, if it's going this way and this is open, it'll go to the right, send out this signal to get this. Now what this does, I'll show you in a second. It's important for the clock. Now this will activate the clock. It's the two, pulls out the one. This is actually what I started with, a little clock. So this makes it send out right as that, while these two wait for that. It sends out the signal, and it starts. Now the clock is facing this way, so it goes around through that. It pulses once, it comes back, it makes it a second time, just as this activates and closes. Then it gets to here, and doesn't work anymore, because the signal isn't complete, because once this is gone, it can't transfer through a block, because it can't go through midair. So that's done. And then this is set up so that the signal can be passed through all the way to the pistons. Now this one goes to the first piston, which is delayed enough time so that the lower piston can push up while that pushes forward. The delay for the timing is a little much, but this one, then it goes to this, the upper one, which pushes down and pulls back up just at the right time to collect it. This goes around to the other one, which gets delayed just enough time to wait for that to push one out. And it's also, and then on when it's on the closed side, it sends the right amount of signal to push out and pull back. Now, that's it for the closed, for the open, except for this. The signal gets sent out, the timer gets used, and it clicks through. I have, I think, 1, 2, 3, 4, is that 5 or just 4? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I have 6 ones just set to 1 that send out, and this is set to 4, and turn this off so that it pulls down and can be shot to, but it's also connected to the clock right here, so it gets 2 pulses. Now on the closed side, when this is out, this gets sent over. Now this is the exact same. It's another clock set to it, because I need to have it on the same rotational on and off thing. So it's all set up here, and it climbs up these steps to send out 2 signals. Now one goes this way and activates these pistons. It activates this piston, which is timed to go out and push it just in time to the going down and ups of the lower piston. This one is also, it goes to this signal, and then this one goes to this, which lets it pull out a block or push it in. But in this case, for closing, it is pushing it out. And if you see, the blocks are all, well, one of the blocks is here, and then the other blocks are already there. And once that starts, it gets pushed over, and then this block gets contained here. It doesn't actually go into the door at any time. It's just used for pushing and pulling and making it all work out. Anyway, yeah, the second signal that goes is over, and, well, this also, it sends 2 different signals so that this gets the upward, and then it connects to this one. And that's why there's a repeater over here to make it so that when this signal gets connected from this side, you know, from over here, then it can't come back from this and activate the clock on this side. Anyway, it's really complicated. I'm sure you could find an easier... well, it's not too complicated. I mean, it's a little easy, most of it. It took me only, like, an hour to figure out and build, but the reason why it took so long... all this was easy, all the clocks and everything. The real thing was the timing. Timing is really hard with this redstone. So, you really need a... That's really the only tough part about the redstone. Along with remembering what each logic gate does. Each logic gate does, and when it comes in handy. Anyway, Caleb didn't think I could build this. And here it is. It's so wonderful. And it looks nice, too. If the wall was pushed back one, which isn't really possible because of how I set it up, I'm pretty sure I could have just put it so that it goes to that, and then I could have pushed the wall back. Anyway, but that's, it's not too important. Yeah. It would show a bit, but I could have brought it instead of up this way. See, I could have just put that second block here and brought it up. Actually, I'm gonna do that. Hopefully this doesn't somehow mess it up completely. Shouldn't affect anything. And now we can bring our wall back. And there's nothing here to be activated. And this side, nothing is in the way. Excellent, see? Completely unnoticeable, except for this little part, which you could have as like a roof or something, so it's not noticeable at all. And then you could hide the button, or you could just leave it out. Anyway, one thing I learned from making all of this was that it's harder than you think to make these. So next time I see a redstone contraption did like an adventure map or anything, I'm not just gonna be like, that's average every day. I'm gonna be like, wow, that's amazing that these people spend all this time to build it. Anyway, yeah, I haven't recorded episode 3 of that yet. I think that will be tomorrow. But thanks for watching. This is getting a little long, 1725. It's probably longer now. Anyway, yeah, thanks for watching. If you want to see more redstone things like this, except next time it won't be a 2x1 gate. It'll be like some amazing things. Yeah. If you enjoyed, subscribe so you can see more, and like and favorite so you can watch it again if you enjoyed it that much, or just like to show your support. Oh, comment if there's like anything I can do to maybe help you with redstone. It doesn't, no matter how hard it is, I'm sure if I spent enough time I could figure it out, because this, I've never done anything like this before, and it only took me like an hour to figure out. I don't mind spending all the time trying to figure it out. But yeah, so if you need any help, or if you know how I can make this shorter, leave a comment. Or if you want to suggest what I should make in next video, leave a comment as well. And yeah. Oh, or if you can make a more compact one, leave a video response so that I can see how to make it, and I'll mention you in the next video. And then I will use yours if you say I can, just like, I don't know, in the description put yes, you can use it or something, and then I'll use it in another video, how to make a more compact one, and I'll mention your name. So yeah, see ya.